Okay. First of all, I want to thank the organizers of this conference. It's a great pleasure to be here on this conference in honor of Ilya Rips. So, the main topic of this talk is construction of finitely presented nillsemigroup. This is joint work with Alexei Kanel-Belov. And we just load this the paper on this work to the archive. So I think at the evening today, everyone can load this paper and enjoy it. So first of all, I want to mention the Bar-Ilan problem. Is Bar-Ilan problem is well known direction of research of in algebra. So this is a much complicated problem, and there are many unknown facts here. So it is this fact. Finitely generated group of period n, is it finite? For small numbers, it's a good situation. So it's always so finite. It's always finite. But for big numbers, we have some brilliant construction. So there are counterexamples of this fact. Here we can see the finitely presented case of Bar-Ilan conjecture. Is there exist an infinite finitely presented periodic group? This question is open now. We have some progress here. So all these people are here now, so it's good results, but the main question is open. So in finitely presented case, there are some open questions for not only for groups but for rings and nillsemigroups. Latyshev states this question for nil rings. So is there exist an infinite finitely presented nil ring? For rings and semigroup, we need to consider non-periodic objects, but nil objects. So we consider here nil rings and nil semigroup. And nil object consists. Okay, nil ring is a ring that all elements of it are nil elements, and nil element is that such that for some power it equals to zero.
So you're assuming that your semigroup can be
every this nil ring or nil semigroup obviously contains zero element. So these two questions are still very interesting, and our talk now dealing with the following question: is there exist an infinite finitely presented nillsemigroup, stated by Lev Naumovich Shevrin?
Zero element means that zero times x equals zero for every.
Yeah, yeah. Zero element times to every other element would be zero, equals to zero. So we construct these objects answer to this question, and we think that this would be help us to construct this object for needle ring, and maybe it would be some ideas to construct for group constructions. Okay, let us consider some possible ways to construct these finitely presented objects. The main, in order to construct these semigroups, we need to control the consequences of the defining relations. So there are three possible ways to control the consequences: Gröbner basis and Diamond lemma, small constellations theory, and realization of Turing machine or Minsky machine. So this here we can see a free approach, and for finitely presented semigroups or finitely presented objects, we can use this automata approach, the third one. So let's talk about this approach. In this approach, letter of alphabet is the inner state of automata, and the world is a chain of automata. This approach can be good in some constructions, so we can construct we can construct finitely presented semigroups with recursive Gelfand-Kirillov dimension, which is big enough, and we can provide a negative solution of Latyshev question. It was construction a ring with finite Gröbner basis and undecidable zero divisors problem. So it is undecidable to determine for given element G, is it zero divisor or not. But this automata approach is not good enough to construct finitely presented nillsemigroup. It's more complicated question. In this approach, we can consider the world as self-organized automata. So it should examine itself and find is there some power of world or not. If it contains some power, it should turn to zero. So in this approach we can't construct this semigroup. So we need to provide some additional ideas here. This is the old slide. So we can see this question, and here we can consider some another approaches of this problem, and the new idea to consider a tilings. So the main point of this problem is to obtain the global property nillsemigroup with local tools, finite number of defining relations.
No.
It n may be various different for various elements. Yeah. It can be bounded, so we can provide the construction for bounded n, but it's some more technicalities, but it can be done. With Stock it is not bounded condition. The main point of this problem is to obtain the global property with local tools, finite number of defining relations. But in our world, world of tilings, it is standard question. So to construct a non-periodic tiling with the final set of tiles. So tiling or tiling is okay. Next slide, I provide this. What I can say. So on this slide we can see that for monomial case, this semigroup always contains periodic elements non-equal to zero for monomial case. And the monomial case in tilings, if we translate this language to tilings, so we can we want to multiply some tilings left, right, and upside down side when we can so we can use a periodic tiling construction for semigroups. So here some tilings. I draw some pictures here. This is the well-known Penrose tiling. So there are two types of rooms here, and we have finite conditions how to took two rooms to another rooms, and this is a finite set of conditions, but only aperiodic tilings can be provided to the plane. So this is another construction, Robinson tiling. Here we actually we have a tiling of squares. So these squares can be assembled to another squares, and these conditions are called boundary conditions. So we can see that we find a set of tilings and the finite set of boundary conditions can provide the tiling that only can be aperiodic on the plane. Yeah, tiling on the plane. This is some additional ideas to the construction, how to use the tiling on the plane, but in our construction, we need to provide some more additional ideas to use some more technicalities.
In our construction, we tile not the plane, but more complicated space.
Okay, we will talk about it. We will talk about it, and there are some technicalities about it. Mm-hmm. So I can go step by step. So let's talk about. This is where well-known tilings, and these tilings have the good property. The finite set of conditions provides the global property on the plane. So only a periodic tiling can be provided by this tiling. So we can see some connections between semigroups and tiling on this slide. So my monomial relation in semigroup is the prohibiting boundary condition in tiling. The word in semigroup would be APF on the tiling, APF on the mosaic. So our question to convert any periodic world to zero using defining relations. Yes, on the edges. Yes. So we want to answer this question: how to convert any periodic world to zero using defining relations. But in tiling world, is a typical question: how to interdict periodic tilings using boundary conditions. And this question can be typically solved by using hierarchic tiles. So there are some theorem about this, Goodman-Strauss theorem in tiling. States that any tiling can be constructed such way that can be cut by some pieces, and the boundary conditions on these pieces can be set such way that only hierarchic construction can be provided by these tilings and these boundary conditions. So this is two possible questions typical in tilings, but is what we need in semigroup. So this this translation to tiling language could be good for us. With another idea, the language of path. As I said before, the path on the mosaic would be a world in semigroup. But a letter in the semigroup would be type of nodal point in the mosaic. There are a finite number of nodal point, and the sequence of nodal point would be path on the mosaic, and it would be a world in the semigroup. So monomial relation with some word equals to zero means impossible path on the mosaic. So this path is impossible, so we can't move here by this edge. So this corresponds to monomial relation in semigroup. And we, by some mosaics, we can provide a finite number of such impossible small paths. So there would be a finite number of monomial relations. So all these impossible paths are bound in our semigroup. So for relations of equal worlds, these two worlds are equal, corresponds to equivalent paths of on the mosaic. So this path would be equivalent to this one on the mosaic. So it would be some relation in semigroup. So this approach, language of paths, is good for describe the semigroup relations by construct a tiling. Okay, let's consider some additional ideas. If only aperiodical tilings are possible, so we can every periodic path on the mosaic should be equals to zero. So every ring path, if we goes by the ring several times, it would be periodic path. So these paths should be bent. And good way to fix this it's to ban all non-geodesic paths. All non-geodesic paths, like this one, we have more shorter way here, and this way is more longer. So we want to forbidden, we want to ban all non-geodesic paths. So we construct a hierarchical tiling such that all periodic paths are forbidden or can be converted to forbidden paths. So we should provide a tool. So we need to provide a tool for considering which paths are periodic. This tool is on this picture we can see some local transformation of some path. If we have some path of this one by the arrows, we can transform it first one by this one, second one by this one, and the third one by this one. So these three cells can play the role of defining relations. So it's similar to Van Kampen diagram here, but this is not a Van Kampen diagram. This is tiling and paths on the tiling. So our path can scan the near part of tiling by local equivalence. Yes, but it may contain the periodic geodesic, but we can construct such tiling that cannot be contained. It's not for every tiling we consider. We construct the special tiling for our need, for our purposes. So this is the important fact that for any points on the tiling, for any points of two points of the tiling, A and B, where exists a wide bunch of geodesic paths. So all these paths are geodesic, and any two of them can be transformed one to another, but by using local transformations. So so the space of this tiling on this construction organized as elliptic type. This is not hyperbolic situation here. So for any two points, there are many geodesic paths between them, such as for North Pole and South Pole on the sphere. So there are many ways to North Pole to the South Pole, and all these paths are equivalent. So here we can construct the similar situation. So any two paths can provide for any two paths we can provide a wide bunch of geodesic paths. Okay. So let us talk about the in more detail construction. So this is the base of our construction. This is hierarchical cutting. One tile, this is one tile, this square, can be cut onto six smaller tiles. We are interested only in topology of this tiling, so these squares can be not the square itself, but we need only to see that this is topologically squared. So here we can see the tile of level 2. This is some rules of hierarchical tiling here. And it's easy to see how we can provide the level of 3 and the more higher levels. And we can see that every point of on this on this complex would be finite degree. For every point, there are finite number of edges goes to it. Another property of this construction is that every path from one point on the perimeter to the another, to the half of the perimeter, can be locally transformed to the path on the another part of the perimeter. So if we consider this path, it can be transformed firstly by this one, then by this one, by this one, by this one. So we can transform it to this way. When we can transform this way to this one, and so on. So this is a hierarchical construction, specially designed for flipping defining relations. So in semigroup, this flipping, that so this two edges goes to this one, would correspond to defining relation in semigroup.
So every
node has a label, and every edge have some coding. So we need to code some nodes and edges, and the path on this complex would be coded by some letters, finite number of letters. So it would be a word in semigroup for every path. It's more complicated. There are two different class of points in the inner points in this macro tile. Here, this one, and this one. So in this macro tile, we are here. These three points. So this is inner nodal point, but as we can see, we can provide some edge points, this one. So this is edge point for upper side of this tile and the right side to this tile. And here we can see the right side of this tile and the downside of this tile. So there are finite types of these edge points, but there are many points, but it is finite number of these. For nodes, we can nine type of nodes, but there are some additional types of nodes we can construct more later. To enlarged with construction. So this is 9 base part of points, base types of points. So this construction is designed for the base construction for semigroup, but in order to provide this property.
So you read the relators on this cell, right? So every H must actually have a direction, right? The H's have directions, so you cannot go by H.
Yes, we provide some coding of edges. So if we have a sequence of the nodal points and the sequence of incoming edges at oncoming edges, so we can correspond to the path on this complex on the world in semigroup. So we need to code the nodes and incoming, outcoming edges, outgoing edges, and incoming edges for each point. So this is some technicalities. So it's more complicated talk. So if you want, we want to talk about it.
But the main point is that it's a directed graph.
We can pass through this edge by this one, but we can walk and by this one too. So we can walk in every direction. So it's not an oriented graph.
The path is directed, but the graph is
blocked. Every time. In our situation that we examine some word in semigroup, we always have some word. We always have some word in semigroup. So we always we can see the path, some path on the mosaic, and this path is obviously oriented. So we can transform it by this defining relation, but all the graph itself would be not oriented. This is all possible defining relations, so it's not be oriented. So this is some picture how to this path can be transformed locally to provide a wide bench of geodesic paths. If we have this path, we can locally transform it by these relations, this one to this one, and then this one to this one, and also we can go to this direction, this side, and to this side. So we can locally transform these paths to wet condition to wet condition. So here we can see, can we visualize where wide bunch of geodesic paths. All these paths are geodesic, and it can be transformed one to another by local transformations. These local transformations would be defining relations in semigroup.
All relations are just where two letters equal to another.
Yeah. All flip defining relations would be of this type, but always, as I said before, we can provide some finite number of impossible small paths, and this is possible small paths would be would correspond to monomial relations. So some word would be equals to zero, and also we can provide some finite type of relations to locally non-geodesic paths. If the paths non-geodesic, it would be also goes to zero, and non-geodesics goes to zero, and using the flip relations, we can transform some long path, long non-geodesic path can be transformed to the form that contains some subworld, small subworld of locally non-geodesics. Yeah.
Every global non-geodesic can be transformed to some path and who is locally non-geodesic somewhere.
Okay. So here is some coding of paths. So every edge on the inner edge on my macro tiles can be coded by this way. Every side and every edge can be coded. There are 16 number of codes, and this is codes for types of nodal points. This is A, B, C for inner nodals. And left, up, right, and down for edge nodals. So if left side goes to up side, so we have some combinations of left, up, down, right, and so on. There are only finite number of possible combinations, so there are no other types of nodals can burn. Where only this type. We can consider in more detail this construction, but it can be easily shown. To
the question is, so why do you need to have different types of edges?
Because of that some more technical question in this construction is to provide this defining relation define relation to how to transform which flip to this one, and so we need to if we know the codes of these nodals and the codes of these edges, we need to know the codes of this node and the codes of these edges to provide the code of this path. So we can use some combinatorial information about our paths. We can use some codes of nodes, and we need to provide the four nodal if we know the first three one. For any tile, if we know the three the codes of three these points and the codes of these edges, we need to provide the code of this one. So there are more technical explanations how to use it, how to provide all the possible cases for all possible conditions. But in order to do this, we need to use a wide number of codes and a good system of coding of these edges. So we need it for this realization of flip relations. Some additional technicalities. In order to provide this property, with the main elliptic property, we need to construct additional pasting, to our planar complex. Before this moment, we have a planar construction, some planar tiling, and here we can construct some additional pastings for any two edges on our complex. We need to pasting some additional macro tile of this type, so we can use some additional relations using the edges and nodes of this macro tile. This macro tile has the same type as the planar one, so it can be provided that there are only finite number of nodal points, nodal codes, and edge codes can be used in this construction to provide this pasting. So, but the construction and the visualization of this construction would not be planar in this way. And here is visualization of some edge. This is edge of big type. Many hierarchic moves were done here. And if we consider this big edge, so it would be constructed many types of this pasting, but in every point, we can provide that there are finite number of codes we need to code these types of these points on this edge. But the construction is quite complicated here. With some finite pastings. In
is also plane.
Yes. Planes. Yes, planes on the with some planes. We can cut some planes on the other planes and pasting some planes to the some pastings. So this would be more complicated construction, but combinatorially, it can be. Considered as a finite type of codes, so every path can be coded by finite number of letters. Yeah, so it would be a good visualization, good for our semigroup construction. So here we can see 10 possible types of flips. These flips corresponds to defined relation in semigroup. So in tile of the smallest possible tile, we can see that there are 10 types of such flips. So these two edges goes to this one, these two edges goes to this one, and so on. There are only finite number of flips, and if we want to set up some defined relations of this type, we need to find the code of the fourth nodal in each situation if we know the free nodal for each case. So if we have a code of this path, we can provide the code of this path. So if we have a this code, we can provide this code. So this is local transformations of codings. If we have a coding on the semigroup, so we have a word, and we have a finite list of defined relations, and every defined relations corresponds to some flip of this type. So if we have some word, we can locally transform it by using these flips and transform our path to another geodesic form. And this transformation can be provided only in the case if our paths correspond, if our word correspond to some path on the regular mosaic. And every our word that someone brings to us some word, and we consider it and using some defined relations on it, and if it word is not corresponds to path on the regular mosaic, so we can provide a local transformations to transform it to zero form. So if okay.
Flips are not enacted.
What?
You have here 10 possibilities of flips, right?
So,
but actually, it could be more combinatorial possibilities that you do not use. Can you just?
Yes, some possibilities do not use because we not use it in all the construction. So we need only 10 possibilities of this one. This one to this one, for example, there are many of such ways. But we need only in these 10 relations. So it's a good one for provide some transformation where form to of this perimeter to this one. We only use these 10 relations. So. This is 10 relations, but we can consider where much more possible situations that the macro tile can be stated in the mosaic. So in these possible various possible situations, these codes can be correspond to various defined relations, but for every case we have finite possible set of these defined relations. This is more complicated thing, but I have no time here to provide all the possible explanations of this fact. But I can do it in another time.
If you add all the missing flips, you get the finite semigroup, right?
No, we can add these additional flips, but this is not good for reconstruction because for these flips we need to provide a big list of explanations and codes. So if we want to add another flip, we need another more pages for this.
Every flip is just a relation for several relations, right?
Yeah. No, it would be always infinite because our semigroup consists of elements corresponds to paths on the geodesic paths on the mosaic, and we can provide a big one path for every length of path. We can use some big path, so we have infinite number of these paths.
In principle, you can add all the paths.
Yes. Yes, but in some technical circumstances, we need to use only these 10 because we are more complicated considerations for this. Okay, here we can see some possible flipping. Here we can see this path on the edge, so we can use these flips to provide that. Here we can use this property for our construction. So in this picture we can see that how to transform locally our paths from this form to this one. So we start with this, goes to here, goes to here, goes to here, and to here. If we have a more complicated situation, we can transform this form to this one, and to this one, and to this one. So all this construction is a good example of a new computational way to construct defining relations and finitely presented objects. So this is computational form of this. So using these such conditions, we can provide some computations and construct some complicated finitely presented objects by this way. So here we can see some of the cases that I mentioned before. So if we have this flip and the codes of it, we should provide how to find the code of this F node. So if our tile is situated like this one, so we need to provide these relations for every possible cases. So there are more complicated. There are more cases of this type. There are like 40 possible cases, and for these 40 cases, we have 10 possible flips, as I mentioned before. And for this, for all these flips, we need to find the codes of these flip paths. Okay, so I described some possible ideas of the construction, but it's more complicated, and if someone wants to discuss it, I ready to it. Thank you for attention. What?
Do you have a way to translate Gelfand-Kirilov dimension to tiling?
Gelfand-Kirilov dimension. I think it's a good question, but I did not think much about it. I think it's a good way to examine this situation, consider some Gelfand-Kirilov dimension in a tiling form. Maybe it would be some results here.
Okay. The words of length n and your the longest power you need to raise, the highest power you need to raise the word in order to make
it? The smallest power boundary for a boundary of n for construction. I think we can use some additional technicalities to provide to a smaller n. Every squared word of in this semigroup would be zero. For n equals to 2. Maybe it's always possible. I think we can provide this situation because we can construct some special mosaic, some special complex where no equal paths one to another. So it would be the construction for semigroups which contains that the property that every word to the power of 2 is equal to 0.
But so far, I think even this construction, you can bound somehow exponent.
Even in this construction, we can provide that n not much enough, but it's I haven't computed the exact number of n of this, but it can be done by future papers of this topic. For groups, there are more complicated situations because we have a brilliant tool for to make word as zeros, because if we have a forbidden path, we can provide the short word, make monomial equation, monomial relation, and it goes to zero. In groups, we can do such thing. So it's more complicated situation. So we need to some construction how to deal with forbidden words in group situation. So, but maybe this construction can be provided in groups too. I think I have some ideas about it, but it's only ideas. So we think that after this construction, we can provide the construction for rings, for nil rings, the Latoshev question. And after that, maybe we can try to construct the group construction, group situation.
Какая особенность все-таки групп провоцирует то, что делается в теории групп, по сравнению с тем, что чего нет вот полугруппа, вот возможность?
Ну, основное отличие. Okay, the main case is that in groups we have not zero element, so we can't provide some monomial relations in group. In this construction, we can ban some bad paths on the mosaic, some bad words by defining these words to zero. And groups, we can't do this. In group, we can't do this. So in groups, it's more complicated case. So we need to provide some complicated construction to ban every word or not equals to unity. We can. I I can talk about it, but it's more complicated situation in groups. I only have where some ideas about it, but it's more complicated case.
Я думаю, что не в этом дело, не ноль единица, а в группах есть действие, и все-таки это действие как-то постоянно фигурирует, а его нет, этого действия нет в полугруппах и просто.
Ну, maybe this one always, maybe.